They say that time will heal a broken heart, and those old memories, they too in time will part. About time is all, oh, it's all a lie. It ain't over till your heart says goodbye. Oh Lord, they say that.
Wow. I must admit, some of my best work. I just love creating. If only I can create some sense of peace in my marriage. I hope this weekend gets us back in a better place. This could very well be our last hope of finding our way back to each other.
Man, I made a mistake.
You have Daniel, man.
How? And when?
No, man, I made a mistake, man. I tried to break it off, but she won't back off.
When have you known a woman like that to back down from what she wants? Do you see how she is with business?
Crazy thing is, you're right, man. She's probably even worse when it comes to, well, relations.
Damn, Daniel. What you gonna do?
I don't know, man. She's threatening to go to my wife.
You picked the wrong woman to screw with her wife's back.
I didn't pick her. It just kind of happened.
Come on, man. Have you seen her? That didn't just happen. On the other hand, if you don't want her, I'll take her.
Really?
Okay. All right, for real though, man. You know you're wrong.
You got a good woman at home, man. Women like that are rare.
That's true. I had a good one some long time ago, and I messed up. I never got her back. Don't be like me, man.
You listening to our conversation, Mr. Frank?
I'm like, really? What the hell?
Not cool, Frank. But he is right, though. You don't want to end up old and lonely like him.
The scars will heal himself.
Really, this man, listen to me.
Wow,
you're
early.
Yep.
Not for long. The guy hired me to prepare a meal for him and his fiance. And he plans to propose.
Oh, how sweet. Must be a good guy to plan something so thoughtful. I remember when you used to be thoughtful.
Don't start, Adelia. Please. Not today, okay? I only have a short time to prepare for these meals. And I don't need any distractions.
Distractions. Right. A distraction.
That's all I've been to you lately. Maybe if I sit on a damn plane with an apple in my mouth, I'd stand a chance of being noticed.
I see you, Adelia. As soon as I walk through the door, you're either whining or complaining about something. Who can ignore that? I sure can't. I see you, Adelia, and I hear you whining and complaining every second of every day. And who's upstairs with our baby?
Shana, you think I'd leave her upstairs by herself? Excuse me, I'll go tend to our daughter.
Say by the name. It was the 4th of July. I told Adelia I had to work a double shift, but I wanted her to meet me at the restaurant so we could at least watch the fireworks together. She was a little disappointed, but agreed. I secretly told her family what I was planning and invited them to be part of the surprise. I also told my boss that I had found the woman I wanted to spend the rest of my life with and wanted to propose. They were all excited and offered to help pull off the surprise. I told Adelia to call when she arrived. I went out to meet her in the parking lot. I told her I was on break so we could watch the fireworks from the dock overlooking the water.
What's all this?
Some guy rented it out for, I guess, him and his fiance, but they're not scheduled to be here till like after the fireworks, so we're good.
Are you sure it's okay for us to be out here?
I asked the coordinator and he said it was fine, just as long as we didn't touch anything. He said anything.
What's wrong?
Nothing. Nothing at all. Just wait right here. Do not move. I'll be right back, okay?
Okay.
Will you marry me?
Oh my God.
Will you marry me, my love?
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Finally get the apartment to myself.
What are you doing? You can't call me. I'm here with my family.
How long are you going to play house? You and I both know that that joke of a marriage was over a long time ago.
I'm not gonna do this with you, Valencia. I asked you not to call me. It's all between us.
Over? You've said that before, but you always come back, don't you? I'm tired of your games. If you can't make a decision, I'm going to help you. It's time for your wife to find out about us.
Us? There is no us. It's over now. Don't call me again. I mean it this time, Valencia.
Is there a problem?
It's over when I say it's over.
Nah, there's something at work, that's all. I got it, man.
Will work interfere with our plans this weekend?
Nah, not at all.
You should check your daughter in before you leave tonight. Oh, and Daniel, I'm not the fool that you think I am.
Everybody plays the fool. There's no exception to the rule. It's time to celebrate, Mr. Chef Extraordinaire. We passed inspection today with flying colors. All thanks to you. You should be very proud of yourself.
But it wasn't just me. Everyone here works really, really hard on a daily basis to make this place the success that it is.
Humble. I love that in a man. But I've been watching you. And trust me, you deserve every bit of praise. And also this glass of wine. Here, drink up. You earned it.
I don't know. I mean, it's been a long day. I mean, I got a long ride home.
Come on, Chef.
Mixing alcohol with exhaustion might not be the best idea.
Come on, Chef. You know you want it. See the way you look at me.
I can't. This is wrong. I got a wife.
She's not here. Nobody has to know. This is between you, me, and that bottle of wine.
Sure, you aren't reading things wrong. It could just be gas running through that gut of yours.
Yeah, I'm serious. It's no time for jokes. I really think something's going on with my husband. I really think there might be somebody else.
Honey, don't get yourself all worked up. You guys are going away for the weekend to work things out. Just talk to him then. Listen, I know from experience that marriage is not easy. Don't go borrowing trouble.
I know, Ma. I can't shake this feeling. You mind watching Jadelia for a while? I think there's something I need to do.
Of course I'll watch her. Now listen, don't go looking for trouble.
All right, Ma.
You just might find it.
Okay, thank you.
No, I love you, baby.
Love you too, Ma. I'll be back, okay, babe?
All right. Come on, let's go play. Yes, come on.
I see you are still doing your thing, Chef. Still making people happy as only you can. And be happy as well.
I thought I told you it was over between us, Valencia. And stay away from me.
Come on, Daniel. Enough with the games. You and I both know that your marriage is over. You and I are good together. Listen to your heart.
I am listening to my heart, Francine. And I'm going home to my wife. I'm sorry if I hurt you. Maybe you can find me in your heart to forgive me.
You don't mean that. Daniel, don't do this. Daniel, don't make me go to your wife.
Goodbye, Francine.
Not. My instincts were right.
Honey, what is it?
He is seeing someone.
No, that can't be true. Daniel wouldn't do that to you or my grandbaby. Are you sure?
Mom, I saw him. I saw them together.
So that's where you went. You found trouble after all. Honey, I need to tell you something.
Thanks for meeting me, bro.
Hey, man, no problem at all.
You want to talk to me? You never guess what happened.
Would you do this differently? Accidentally slept with another woman?
This is no time for jokes, man. For real. And no, I didn't. Valencia followed me tonight.
She means she followed you.
I was leaving a gig I did for a couple. I was packing my stuff up and voila, there she was.
So she's stalking you now?
Man, I don't know what she's thinking, man. She was coming on to me in public. I told her it was over.
So what did she say?
She was pissed. Man, I just know she's gonna go to my wife, man.
Hey, no, thank you, shout out. That's not good.
You telling me?
That's not good at all.
Barton, one more.
Make that two.
Everything okay?
Everything's fine. I just thought I heard you, Delia.
I just passed her room. Sounds she's sound asleep. You coming back to bed?
I'll stay up just to make sure she stays asleep.
Is that her?
What?
I told you before, I'm not the fool that you take me for.
What are you talking about? You know my phone rings a lot because my clients are always calling to book me. You're making a big deal out of nothing.
I saw you the other night, Daniel.
What? You saw me?
I saw you with her.
I tell you, it's not what you think.
What is it? Please tell me.
Let's just get to the cottage so we can talk.
Pull the damn car over, Daniel. Pull over now.
No. Come on. Get back in the car. She's going to upset Jadalia. Oh.
Who is she, Daniel?
Come on, just get back in the car. Let's not do this here. I promise, I'll explain everything. Just get back in the car. You want to get something to eat while we're here?
happened to us?
I don't know. I keep asking myself the same question.
Why are you gonna get that? Looks like they don't stop calling me through the
door. No. This weekend is about us, okay? Ignore it.
If you won't get it, I will.
That's not necessary.
Hand over the
phone.
No,
that's not necessary. I'll just turn it off, okay? Off.
It's her, isn't it? Why else wouldn't you want me to answer the phone? I wonder what she'd have to say to me, huh?
Once again, you're making a big deal out of nothing.
Don't you ever say that to me again. I know what I saw the other night.
And I told you it's not what you think.
When are you gonna be honest with me, Daniel? Oh, wow. You owe me at least that much.
Daniel, we just got here. Can we talk about this later?
Damn it, Daniel! Stop dismissing my feelings. Stop pretending that I'm stupid. I can't even take it.
Well, it's about time someone picked up.
Who is this?
I'm the answer to all of your questions.
It's you, isn't it?
Yes, sweetheart. Haven't you figured that out yet?
What the hell are you talking about? And why are you calling my husband?
Garage door.
Adelia, listen, I can explain. I can explain. Listen, just pay this no mind.
So we gonna pretend that it's all in my head?
I'm sorry, Adele. I made a mistake. I'm sorry, baby. We can work through this. I can't explain why. I don't know why it happened. I was confused. I was lonely.
You were lonely? How in the hell could you have been lonely? You had a wife at home. I can't stand you, Daniel. I can't stand
Chill,
you.
Calm down.
I hate you right now.
Get off of me,
Daniel.
Please.
Daniel, get off of me. Don't touch me, Daniel. I can't believe you did this to me.
Mom and Dad are gonna be okay, okay? You're gonna be just fine. What have I done? How am I gonna fix this? I'm thinking about my family.
Can we talk about this? Please. Let's take a nap, honey.
Can we talk? I don't want to lose you.
There's nothing to talk about. You decided the fate of this marriage when you screwed another woman.
Jadelia, please.
Don't touch me.
Hey, baby.
Was it a one-night stand?
No, it wasn't.
How long has this been going on?
really don't think we should talk about this right now. We got our daughter in the back seat.
It's now or never, Daniel. Tell me the truth.
I spent time with her more than once. But let's not talk about that. We can get through this.
How in the hell are we supposed to go get past this if you keep avoiding it? Tell me now, Daniel.
I haven't seen her for a few months, but I broke it all. I know I was wrong. I promise you and our daughter this won't happen again. I promise I'll never hurt you again.
A few months, Daniel? I don't think I can forgive you for this. I hate you.
What? Not the...
Why does it feel like I'm forgetting something?
I never thought things would end up this way between us.
I'm so sorry. I never meant to hurt you, Delia. I made a stupid mistake.
Why, Daniel?
There's no excuse for me, for what I did to us.
How could you let this happen?
Weak. I let myself in the camp, did it? It had nothing to do with you. I'm an idiot. I took for granted what we had.
I would never be unfaithful to you, Daniel. You had all of me. Why wasn't it enough?
You are enough. More than enough. I just didn't see it. I mean, I love you, Adelia. I can't bear the thought of losing you.
I don't know if I can get past this.
Please forgive me. I never meant to hurt you, and I promise you I'll never hurt you again.
How can I trust you?
The one thing you can trust is that you have my heart.
Yes, it is.
What is it? Blood pressure is 134, 86. Our rates are 82 sinus.
Oh.
98%.
Oh, my God.
This time, ETA.
Please tell me that my daughter and granddaughter are okay.
My goodness, this seems like such a long ride. Seems like we're never going to get home.
Honestly, I don't even want to go home if it means losing you.
Don't you think it's too late to think like that? You broke my heart, Daniel.
I knew I did. And I regret it. But I know we can get past this.
How?
I just start by taking responsibility for what I did to us. You can start by maybe trying to forgive me. God, I know I messed up. Hey. I made the worst mistake I could have ever made. Hurt my wife. And now my marriage is on the line. You know I love Adele, you know our daughter. I just lost my way for a minute. There's no doubt in my mind. I know I want my family.
God, please forgive me and help my wife to forgive me.
I'll do
anything to make this.
Forgive?
Yes. I prayed to God and asked for his forgiveness. Now I'm asking you, Adelia. Please forgive me.
What is it, Mom?
Honey, I want you to understand that no one is perfect, that everyone makes mistakes.
But Daddy wouldn't do something like this to you, would he?
No, your father was never unfaithful. But I was.
What?
Honey, I'm telling you this because I need you to understand that no one is perfect. I made a mistake, but your father, he forgave me. He loved me enough.
Mom, how could you?
I was young. I had you and your brother. I was working and things were rough. And your father was always working. I felt lonely. My coworkers started paying attention to me and giving me compliments. We started spending time together.
How did Daddy deal with it? Did he leave you?
I started getting flowers and with sweet notes, but no signature. At first, I thought they were from my coworker, but then I started getting notes on my pillow that said, I don't want to lose you, and you will always have my heart. It was then that I knew that I made the worst mistake of my life.
How did Daddy find out?
He never said. He sat me down one night and told me that he loved me no matter what. He said he didn't need to know, and he didn't want to know anything. But he wanted me to understand that he forgave me. And then he asked that I forgive him for leaving me to feel alone. He told me to always remember the love between us, and that love conquers all.
Wow. That's some kind of love. You were lucky.
Yes, I was. And I held on to that love until the day he died. And I'm still holding on to that love. Adelia, forgive your husband. Not for him. For you.
She has a left-sided abdominal evisceration, multiple abrasions to the left side of his forehead. We have an 18 established EKG.
Sweetheart, I want you to know that Mommy and Daddy loved you very much and that they only wanted the very best for you. I'm sure that they found their way back to love before they went home. Now it's just you and Grandma. I'm going to make sure that you know all about your mommy and daddy. Your mommy was very creative, and your daddy was an amazing chef.
Time.
apart, and what they say about time is all, oh, it's all a lie. Nobody